There was a wealthy man who had two sons that he adored so much. Hardworking and detail-oriented, he did his best for a comfortable life his sons deserved. When the two brothers came of age, they took their places in their father's company. The elder son, Reuben, worked diligently to impress and make his father proud, while Benjamin, the younger one, wasn't that interested of being stressed inside boring gray walls. Despite their differences, their father loved them the same, and he hoped and prayed for both of their successes. But a day came when Benjamin made a decision that can hinder his father's yearning.
Father! Oh, yes, Benjamin. I had a dream last night.
Really?
And what was that? I was seeing the biggest cities in the world.
Well, that's great.
And everywhere I go, everybody likes me because I'm smart and wealthy.
Of course, son. That's what you are.
You know, Father, working at this company is fine for you.
Of course.
But not for me. I have to do the things I have to do, the place I have to see.
What? Then you're leaving?
Well, yes, Father. And you promised Reuben and me our inheritance. Money for us.
Yes, I did. But I'm saving that for your future.
But, Father, I want my share now. I have to do what I have to do.
His father didn't know what to do. He wouldn't want his son to leave, but he also didn't want him to stop living a life he wanted. Pushing aside his doubt, he handed his son his share with renewed trust in his eyes.
Here you go, son.
Thanks, Father. I'm rich.
Hey, that's not fair!
Benjamin can't just take his money like that.
Don't worry, Ben. He can take the money and he can do it whatever he wants.
Don't worry about the company, Father. Ruby's here.
I'll miss you, my son.
Don't worry about me, Father. I'll be alright.
God bless and have a safe
life. Thank you, Father.
He watched his son leave. He wanted to stop him. He wanted to scold him like a little boy he was back then. But his son is a grown man. He knew this day would come, and all he can do is whisper a prayer for his safe boy. When Benjamin set foot outside their house, he knew freedom would taste exquisite. Finally, he could go wherever he wanted, buy anything, and just feel liberated from the boring work-filled minds of his family. Benjamin didn't spend, he splurged. Party after party, women to sleep with, drinks making his blood boil. He was loving every second of it.
Good afternoon, Father.
Father, I have done the heavy works on the cover. And I'm trying to keep this. I've paid the bills of the company and the house. So, you don't need to worry. Thanks for the hard work taking us. You know what? I'm really worried about Benjamin. I don't know if it's alright. Come on, Father. Dinner's ready.
Benjamin made new sets of friends from his money. He wasn't thinking about the consequences he would face later. A few years after, he noticed that his money was already dry. He went to his friends, but his friends won't acknowledge him anymore because he was broke. For the first time, he felt very alone. He tried to find a job so that he can eat and support himself.
Oh, I'm sorry. Do it again.
You missed him!
He was desperate, so he accepted a job as an all-around boy. He was treated like a slave. With little earnings, he could barely eat. After a month, he couldn't take it anymore and thought about his father's house.
Take this anymore.
She treats me here like a slave. This is not what I wanted. My father's house. I can eat. And I can sleep properly. Even the tenants do. But I'm going home.
So Benjamin travels back home. He hoped and prayed that his father would accept him back and won't send him away. It was a Sunday morning and there was no work. The father stared out the horizon and saw someone coming. It was getting closer. Without a doubt, he knew who it was and he rushed towards him.
Everyone! Benjamin's back!
I think this is a bad idea. Father wouldn't even talk to me.
As Benjamin nears their home, he couldn't stop overthinking about the things that could go wrong and the things his father could say.
I will do anything. I will work for you. Please. Please take me back. I may be unworthy, but I promise that I will.
Welcome back home, my son. I'm so happy that you're safe and sound. So come on, let's celebrate.
Everyone, prepare lots of food and give him something to wear. For my son has returned.
No, that's wrong.
Sir, is this okay?
No, that's wrong.
The celebration started. Everyone was happy, and Benjamin realized how his father loved him.
Hey,
but his father had noticed something. He didn't saw Reuben, so he went through the house to find him, and he saw him outside.
My son, why are you here? You're missing the celebration of your brother.
It's not fair, father. All these years I've been working for you. Never did I disobey your orders. Yet, you never let me celebrate with my friends. But when your lazy son comes back home, you throw him a big fist.
Ruben, my son, you're always with me, and I'm very grateful for you. What I have is always yours. If you want to throw a big fist, then go. A party, then do it.
Sorry, father.
Forgiveness doesn't come easy, as pride blocks it from us. But a heart full of unconditional love can overcome it and fill someone with hope. Is there a feeling greater than being loved? Alas, there is also no greater force than it. When it overflows, hope follows. And there is the promise that hope will blossom into a tree of life.